Hi guys, what's up? Hey, I just want to say I'm sorry that I haven't posted anything for a long time. I've been traveling, so last time I went to Bali and then to Hong Kong, but this blog is basically a little bit about Hong Kong. So basically, I've recorded some of the things using just like my simple phone. So if the footage is not that great, I apologize. So I traveled with my mom.
Mom's face when she's cranky.
And just like a quality time with her. It was quite amazing. And the mother-daughter bonding time was quite good. So, my friend from Hong Kong took me around this like really good food. I've tried this, like I heard this noodle place is amazing, but too bad that there's too many people. I don't want to wait, so I'm just gonna go stroll around that area and do a little bit of shopping.
No, on Wellington, right?
Under the escalator?
Yeah.
That one's alright.
This is amazing, man. And noodle place. I'm just waiting for this place. You guys, apparently there's a lot long line over there. It's for this noodle place in Gough Street. I heard that's really good. So when you go to Soho area, just come by this place and try the soup.
Favorite area is Causeway Bay, and that is totally shopping central. And if you go there, well my mom always go to Sogo. It's like the biggest thing, is like the thing there. They have plenty of good food, Japanese food, downstairs in the basement, I think. And there are some things that are just quite unique that you have to try from there. As a coincidence, on day two there's an African Australian fair or event. So I've been trying, didn't know that African wines are so good, and yeah, tipsy all the way. Kidding, just kidding.
wine like this is so unique. You don't make it for a hawk, you make it for yourself. So,
don't even think of going to Hong Kong without trying the dim sum. So since my mom only hangs out around Causeway Bay area, so we tried and found this really good dim sum in this building, which I do not know the name of the building and I'm not helping, but I do remember that it is in front of an IKEA store in Causeway Bay. So it's pretty good, but the best one that I heard is Maxim.
YouTube channel. Oh yes.
So good.
And don't forget, get a friend in Hong Kong so that they can, you know, take you around Hong Kong in the like fabulous area. But my suggestion is you definitely have to check out Soho. So when I walk around in Central, I found this amazing Lush store, and then this beautiful lady just took me around the place and showed me what a wonderful place that is to get a spa.
So apparently this place is the largest lush in all Asia. This thing is dark. Hi. Mm-hmm. Hello.
See around like all the wood is actually recycled.
Yeah.
It's all reclaimed. They're actually part.
That sounds amazing.
You can see on the board up here, mm-hmm. we've got the different words.
Okay.
So synesthesia, it's one treatment, but there's actually 11 different variations. So each word has its own atmosphere and
room. I see.
It has its own blend of essential oils that we use.
Uh-huh.
And its own massage routine. So every time you pick one, you're getting a different treatment.
Okay.
You want to smell the...
Sure, sure.
So something like this.
What is that?
These are massage bars.
So oh, okay.
Have you seen massage bars before?
No, well, yeah.
They look a bit like soap, but they're not.
Oh, it's not? It's not a soap?
No,
but there's
no.
Soap ingredients here too, no?
No, it's basically fine essential oils. How smells this one? Fine essential oils set in cocoa butter and shea butter. So they'll sit at room temperature, but uh-huh. they'll melt to your
cool.
body temperature. You'll know, like, Lush downstairs, they sell a lot of music products.
Yes.
They want... to obviously keep things preservative-free, it's also free of packaging.
I
so
see.
That's going to landfill.
True, true. So where's the... It's a spa, so there must be...
Yes. This is a double room, but it's set up for a single
I see.
Treatment.
Ooh, wow. It's dark. This is nice. Oh, wow. Oh my god. Cool.
So yeah, like I was saying, this is our chocolate scrub treatment. In a lot of spas, you know, you have a scrub. You're
yeah.
putting the light on,
is it? Sure.
Yeah.
Well, this is kind of cool as well.
Cool.
Yes.
Like,
wow.
But yeah, with some scrub treatments in spas, mm-hmm. when they put the scrub on you, you sit in it, and then you have to get up, have a shower, and everything.
Yeah.
With us, you just lay in the bed the whole time. This is all heated, so it's nice and warm.
Oh wow.
And we apply a scrub.
Uh-huh.
I'll show you what the scrub looks like. We melt it down so it's all hot, right?
Okay.
Have a smell of this.
Oh, chocolate.
Chocolate,
wow,
right?
Chocolate goodness.
Yeah. So they use the raw cacao
mm-hmm.
as like a natural
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
But there's like azuki beans and coconuts and dates.
Cool.
And that
cool.
provides really nice scrub. So
amazing.
We put the scrub on,
mm-hmm.
we massage through the sheet, we do a
okay.
raw massage, and then we remove it with hot mitts,
mm-hmm.
and then we do the same process on the back of the body, this time we apply it.
Okay.
This is what people lose their minds over.
Really?
They don't sell this on the shop floor.
What is that?
This is the rose serum.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. Oh my god.
Yeah.
You don't sell this?
No.
No.
You want to try a little bit on your arm though?
Sure. I know, it's very good. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
There's actually rose clay inside, so it mattifies on the skin, seeps in really quickly. So it's got argan oil as well.
Okay.
And both of these things have tamarind paste.
Oh, okay.
So tamarind's really sweet and sour.
Wow.
And with the spa, it's kind of like a speakeasy. Like, if you don't know it exists, then you don't know.
Wow.
It's all word of mouth.
Yeah.
So it makes it kind of a secret.
Exactly. Makes it even better, actually.
Yeah.
Ooh. Please come in. Come in. Oh,
this is
like double, like a couple spa.
Yes. And we can easily take the beds down, obviously.
I see.
We need it for a single treatment.
Uh huh.
This is our foot treatment. It's
mm-hmm.
called the spell. It's designed to help you get rid of worry.
Worry?
So within the treatment, you actually cast your own spell.
I see.
You
cast your own spell? This
yeah.
is like, oh, okay. Should bring my mom here, probably.
Yeah. It's really, really beautiful. We actually do, like, it's a foot treatment. We do a foot mask.
Uh-huh.
While the foot mask is on, we actually give you a beautiful scalp massage as well.
I see.
And we pad up and down the body and everything. And then it's kind of like reflexology. So treating
I see.
The body through the feet.
How much is it for a treatment, like, from the range, price range?
It depends. It's usually about
$1,000 and up, okay.
Yeah, yeah.
For like, $1,000 would be like an hour treatment?
Yeah.
Yeah, an hour treatment.
Oh, yeah. And each treatment, you can hear like the different music. Yeah. Because Lush has its own record label.
Uh-huh. Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
So they really take control of like what they put out, right?
And everything, yeah.
So with each treatment, it has its own soundtrack. And when they develop treatments, what they'll do is have a therapist perform it. They'll bring musicians in. They'll see the treatment being done, and they'll start composing music right away. So your whole treatment is actually choreographed to music. That's why when we say you have an hour's treatment, your hour doesn't start till you're on the bed and you can play. So you're usually in the spa for about 2 hours.
Cool.
And I'll show you this room. It's set up right now for good hour.
Oh, wow.
But this one, we can do our latest treatment called Hands of Bath, which is why we have the bath over here.
Okay. Oh, this is amazing. Oh wow, I love this.
I'll tell you about Tales of Bath. Because Good Hour is a deep tissue massage, right?
Okay.
And you might be able to hear it soon, but it's got pirate music.
Pirate?
It's not
It's not soothing, relaxing. Yeah, yeah.
It's like, get the drop done.
Okay.
But with Tales of Bath, totally different experience. So it's all about the healing waters in Bath in the UK. And what happens is you sit in a chair with the big fluffy robe over there.
Big fluffy robe.
You get a beautiful like, shoulder and head massage. And then your therapist leaves you and you get to have a bath on your own in privacy. And you actually listen to this really beautiful poem. At the end of the soundtrack, you'll hear this
Oh really? So that's...
Yeah, and you get out of the
hilarious.
Bath,
okay.
You dry off and you lay on the bed. And you hug a pillow, so you actually have a side lying massage. It's really good for people who don't like laying on their belly, or they have low back tension.
Yes, I do have that.
Or like mothers who are expecting as well. Like pregnancy massage.
I see.
But yeah, we have hot washing massage as well.
I see.
We actually also have a special bath bomb that we use. It's literally
big. Yeah, wow, that's
it's
huge, usually.
It's called the crystal ball bath bomb. It actually blows in the water.
Oh, do you sell that?
No.
Only in the
treatment.
Okay.
We have one that's the same size, which I'll show you downstairs.
Okay. Hello. You look pretty.
All this makeup as well is only available in this shop in Oxford Street in London.
Oh, no wonder. I've never seen the makeup before.
A lot of times you'll see like the liquid lipstick and stuff. But
okay. Is it all natural and stuff like that?
Yeah. Well, obviously in Lush we use
coloring.
Natural, fresh ingredients and all these safe synthetics. Because not always a natural ingredient is the ethical option.
Of course, understandable.
I can show you with this. When you apply makeup, you'll see it's got that shimmer.
Yeah.
Usually what gives that shimmer is something called mica.
Mica,
so
yeah.
Mica is like a mineral.
Yeah.
Normally mined in India by its
Okay, but this one?
Obviously, we don't want to touch that kind of thing.
I see. So, what kind of glitter do you use?
Synthetic mica.
I see.
100% traceable.
I see.
It doesn't hurt harm nature.
Okay.
Cool.
The wonderful lady took me to this like wonderful trip, like a mini tour around that place. It's the biggest Lush store in Asia, I would say. So if you need a spa, an R&R for a day, you should check out Lush, definitely in Central. Okay guys, so the trip was wonderful, it was quite memorable, and don't forget to check out my YouTube channel after this. I'm still gonna be traveling and maybe more tips, and I'm receiving tips as well from you guys if you wanna, you know, add anything. Hey, I know I haven't been posting for quite some time, but don't forget to subscribe and give me ideas if you want me to, you know, eat anything, try anything, or cook anything for you.